Mylee Nordin. I'm the staff beekeeper with the Toronto Beekeepers Co-operative, and today we're here at the Toronto Botanical Gardens, Allen Gardens, and we were harvesting the first harvest, the summer harvest here, from their 4 beehives.
And why did you decide to do it now?
Well, it was more kind of necessity. We have a couple strong hives that brought in a really early spring honey flow, and so we had to harvest those so that we can make room for them to bring in honey for the fall.
Wonderful. And if you could share some stats with us, like how many bees are we talking about that are here at the Toronto Botanical Gardens?
So they have now 5 hives, and one's smaller, but the other ones are quite strong. So we're looking at, probably now that we're at the peak of summer, that there are about 60,000 in each one of those hives. So we're looking at about 250,000 bees, honeybees, in this just area from their bee yard.
Wonderful to hear that. And with the activity, they've been very active and you've got lots of honey production. And what about the quality of this honey compared to future honey for this season?
Yeah, well, as you progress in the season, the honey typically gets darker. So you get from the later summer plants, like buckwheat or sunflowers, a darker, richer honey. But when they come in the spring, it's usually a lighter, which we have today. We have quite a light, kind of borderline golden honey, but it'll be primarily from... Well, here we have such a nice eclectic mix of wildflowers, you know, that they have planted here, but it's a lighter, sweeter honey in some ways.
And is there any plan for this lighter, sweeter honey?
Well, luckily this year too, they have, we did some cut combs. So that is actually the comb that we will cut up and put in the jars. So they have kind of a nice jarring honey. So they're going to do that. And I think the Botanical Gardens is really trying to link it to what they have planted here. So doing tastings and giving people the opportunity of really tasting what the area produces.
And I hear that the quality is so good that they're thinking of using it for a competition. Can you tell us about this competition?
Yeah, so every year in the fall there's the Royal Winter Fair, and they have maple syrup, jams, jellies, and different competitions, and one of the categories is honey. So last year the Botanical Gardens entered, the Royal York entered, the Cooperative entered, and this year they are planning to enter again. And I think they'll probably be in the same category, although we'll see the next harvest. We might get a darker honey, and that would be then 2 separate categories for them to enter.
Wonderful. And the kind of bees that we have here, do you know the type of bee that we are using and what kind of frames that were made for those outgoing escape hatches?
Yeah, so we have here the method that we use, the Langstroth, which is the typical kind of Western and is used primarily around the world. It's about 80% of beekeepers use the Langstroth with the frames in the boxes. And the honeybees, we have a bit of a mix. They're mostly Toronto stock, but some come from kind of a lineage from Buckfast, which is a type of European honeybee that was bred in Europe. And then we have some Carniolans, but they all come from stock, and some are actually locally mated here, so queens that were born here and that have mated with drones in the area.